LEDs, or light-emitting diodes, are fun little components. They let us turn electrical energy into, well, light. You might use them as an indicator on your robot, change the channels from a remote control, or light up the ground you walk on. They are much more efficient than old light bulbs, but they can be a little tricky to use in circuits sometimes. If you were to connect it directly to a power source, like this 9-volt battery, you run the risk of burning it out. Or if you give it more power, even worse things could happen. But as engineers, we usually don't want things to explode on our users. That's generally frowned upon. So how do we protect these little things? We can restrict the current flowing through an LED by using a resistor. Let's say we have something controlling the voltage of the LED, like pin 3 on an Arduino. We add the resistor in series with the LED. This resistor resists the flow of current as it flows through the LED and back to the Arduino through the ground pin. Most basic LEDs can have a maximum of 20 milliamps, or 0.02 amps flowing through them before they get damaged. We know that the current flowing through the LED must be the same current flowing through the resistor, as this is a series circuit. LEDs have a forward voltage. This is the minimum voltage necessary to turn the LED on. Once that voltage is reached, the voltage across the LED will stay at about that level regardless of how high the supply voltage goes. Red, orange, yellow, and some green LEDs will have a forward voltage of about 2 volts. Some green and most blue LEDs will have a forward voltage of about 3.2 volts. We start by solving for the resistor value that will give us 20 milliamps through the circuit, the maximum allowable current. So we start with Ohm's law, V equals I times R, or voltage equals current times resistance. Here's the trick. Ohm's law does not work on diodes, which includes LEDs. It does work, however, on resistors. We can find the voltage across the resistor, which we'll call VR, by subtracting the LED's forward voltage from the supply voltage. Let's assume the Arduino is a 5-volt Arduino, so when we set a pin to high, that pin will be 5 volts. And let's say we're using a blue LED with a forward voltage of 3.2 volts. We can say that the blue LED will use up 3.2 of those 5 volts. This means we're left with 1.8 volts for the resistor. Now, we plug those values into Ohm's law. The voltage across the resistor, 1.8 volts, is equal to the maximum current, 20 milliamps, times the value of the resistor. Solve for R, and we get 90 ohms. We got a resistance value, but it might not work in the real world. You may need to make the LED dimmer to save on battery life, or maybe you're given a set of resistors that you have to choose from because they're already in the design and it'll save on manufacturing costs. If you look at a chart for common resistor values, you'll see that 90 ohms is probably not on there, so we need to pick something else. If we decrease the resistance, we allow more current through our circuit. We've already said that 90 ohms gives us the maximum allowable current through the LED, so we can't go lower than 90, but we can go above it. We look at our chart again and see that 91 ohms is the next highest, so we go with 91 ohms. That'll make the LED the brightest without damaging it. You can always increase the resistance value. It will just make the LED a little dimmer. So for our circuit, we could have used a 100 or 220 ohm resistor. That would have been perfectly fine. It can help to perform these quick math steps to protect your LED next time you want to use one in a design. So be safe and happy hacking.